Hello everyone, today we are going to learn about the topic called microorganism. We are going to do two experiments related to the topic microorganism. So the one experiment will use bottle, balloon, sugar, yeast, sugar and yeast. So I have did it right over here. This one contains yeast, sugar, water, and this one just contains the sugar and water. Okay, so we are going to see it right over here that what did we do. So, we take two bottles, put water and sugar in both of them and put yeast in bottle B. Okay, you can see that the bottle B contains the yeast, not the bottle A. Then, we cover both of the bottle with the balloons. Okay, and we keep that bottle for 3 to 4 days. Okay, after 3 to 4 days, you will see this result. Now, what do you see in your bottle? So I have written down some question which relates to this experiment, which will help you to do this experiment very quickly and understand this topic. So what do you see in your bottle? When I observed my bottle, I was able to see yellow water, some bubbles on the top of water, and including that, I was also able to see my rising balloon. You can see right over here, you can see some bubbles on the top. You can see the yellow whitish water and you can see the rising balloon right over here. The next question. What do you think is happening? I believe that yeast is a fungal that needs supply of energy for living and growth. We added some sugar which gives energy to it. So in some way they are getting active. So we added sugar to the bottle. So sugar will make the yeast active in the bottle. So some reaction will happen. You can see that reaction is rising balloon. Now, what kind of gas is being produced? So there is some type of gas in this balloon. So the balloon is filled with a gas called carbon dioxide. Third, we can go to the next question. Why did we add sugar to the bottle? Each and every living thing needs energy to be alive. Now then we add sugar, it converts into energy and yeast will be active. And through reaction will be seen soon in the balloon. We added sugar because it activates our yeast. Okay, so sugar will give sugar is converted into the energy and yeast will be then get active. Okay, so that's why we added sugar. What kind of changes does yeast cell make in their environment? Okay, each and every living thing has a cell. So even yeast has a own cell. Okay, when yeast cell are grown, they are in rich carbon dioxide sources such as glucose. They prefer to grow by a process of fermentation. Have you heard of the word fermentation? It is called fermentation. During the fermentation, glucose is converted into carbon dioxide. So we had sugar to it. So sugar is converted into glucose, and then because of glucose is added in yeast, it is growing through a process called fermentation. Now, what does the word metabolism mean? Have you heard in our last video, you have heard the word metabolism. So right now also we have the word metabolism. Metabolism is a process by which our body converts what you eat and drink into energy. So the food for our experiment is sugar and it converts to an energy which for yeast and it gets active. Now, here is our yeast cell structure. Okay, it is basically same names, same parts of our body, body cells and animal cells and plant cells, but it is formed with a cell. Okay, this is the cell wall which each and every cell has. Then we have chloroplast, then we have vacuole, then we have cell membrane, then a new type of a part is lipid, then we have nucleus. Okay, basically nucleus are containing each and every cell, I think, in some of them. Okay, yeah. Now we are done with the first experiment. Now let's go to on the second experiment. In second experiment is about the dough, where we use water, yeast, and we use hot water, yeast, and the maida. Okay. Now, you can see over here what is gluten and how it is formed. Wheat and other related grains contain a mixture of two proteins, gluten and gliadin. When flour is made gliadin, these grains are mixed with water. The two proteins combine and form a gluten. Without water, gluten is not formed. Okay. Now, I have shown you over a picture over here. So first, it is gluten. Then it is gluten, and then it is gluten. Okay. So there are some differences in the word, but you have to remember it. Gluten and gluten. Okay. In the flour.
When you add the water.
When you add the water. This happens when you add water in our flour. Means the maida or stuff. Now, the ingredients I used in this experiment of dough, hot water, some yeast, and some maida. Then you mix the all things together, so it will be in a dough. After your dough is ready, you cover it and keep it overnight. Okay, you have to keep it in an airtight container. Now when I just mix my dough. At that moment, my dough diameter was around 6 centimeters diameter. Okay. And after 2 days, my dough was 13 centimeter diameter, 12 centimeter diameter. Okay. So it was double in a size. And that was because of the this process, which is gluten, gluten, and gluten. In the yeast, and this is also the yeast, so it called a go through a process of fermentation. Okay, so now over here we have types of flours. All purpose flours, carbohydrates is 77 gram, and we have different whole wheat flour. Now we have a types of flours over here, which all flour contains protein and carbohydrates in it. Okay, when there is protein, and that when we have our dough, it has the stretch, the stretching things of it. It gets more stretch. If you try to mix the dough and stretch it, it will stretch a lot. Okay, so that is because of the protein. Now carbohydrates is also in the dough. Okay. In the flour, and when we have our ready, when we ready our dough. So these were two experiments of related to the topic of microorganism. Maybe you can try your experiment and share it with me. Bye.